How much part of the Earth's surface is covered with water? Can we use all this water for drinking? 71% of Earth's surface is covered with water. 96.5% of water is present in oceans, which is salty, and hence cannot be used for drinking.
3.5% remaining is found in rivers, lakes, ice caps, and glaciers. Underground, as in wells, soils, and rocks. In air, as water vapor, and in plants and animals.
As you can see, drinking water available to us is very little. We should use this natural resource sparingly. Do you know how much water is present in the human body? About 60% of human adult body contains water. Extra information. At birth, the human body contains 78% water. Adult males have about 60% water. Adult females have about 55% water. Why is water important in our life? Water is very important for us as well as all the living beings. It hydrates our cells and helps in removing the toxins, that is poisonous substances, from our body. Water is used for various biological processes like digestion, excretion, etc. occurring in our body. Can we live without water? No. As water is an important natural resource, let us study its properties. Identify these. Water is found as ice, solid, water, liquid, water vapor, gas. Solid, liquid and gas are the three states of water which are interconvertible. That is, ice can be converted into water or water vapor and vice versa under certain conditions. In which state do you find water under ordinary conditions? Water occurs in liquid state under ordinary conditions. What happens when you pour water on the floor? Can you pour water from a cup or another glass or cup? Can you think which property of water it is? How is it different from solids like rice and rava pouring into a container? Water can flow. That is, water is a fluid substance.
Take a bottle or any container. Take containers of different shapes. Now, pour water in these containers one by one.
Observe. Does it have a particular shape? Water does not have its own shape. It takes the shape of the container in which it is kept. Take a cup or glass. Take a piece of filter paper. Take water in one more container, any bottle or jug of your choice. Keep the piece of filter paper on the mouth of cup or a glass. Then pour water from the container on the filter paper that is placed on the cup or glass. What do you observe? You can repeat the same experiment with a piece of muslin cloth. Has water passed through the muslin cloth or filter paper? Yes, water has passed through and gets collected in the cup or glass. Can you guess the property of water? Yes. Water can pass through very small gaps or cracks. Can you think of any example from daily life where you observe this property of water? Yes. In rainy season, if the wall has cracks, water does seep in from these cracks. Why do we keep a small container below the earthen pot in our homes? Earthen pot has minute holes in it and water seeps in through it, which is collected in this small container. Do you know how is water supplied to a tall building? Water from PMC is collected in the lower tank. This is then lifted by using a pump and sent to overhead tank. This overhead tank is placed above all the floors. This water is then circulated to all the floors. Set up an apparatus as shown. Does water flow from A to B? Yes. Now repeat the same by filling water in B. Does water flow from B to A? No. Why? Water always flows from higher level to lower level. Let us make a vessel. For this, you will need 1 liter bottle of soft drink. Take 200 ml, 500 ml bottles, cut their bottoms. Open the caps of these bottles. Now, Pour water through any of the vertical bottles. Note down your observations. After the bottle A is filled, water rises equally in all B, C and D arms, irrespective of quantity contained in each of these. What property does it show? Water has the property to seek its own level.
Take a bucket or any container.
Fill it half with water. Drop different articles like stone, cork, pencil, rubber, etc. one by one. Prepare a list of items that A. sink in water, B. float on water. Does ice float on water or does it sink in water? Ice floats on water. Why? Some items float on water whereas some sink in water because of the property called density, that is heaviness. Density is equal to mass divided by volume. Unit gram per cubic centimeter. Gram per cubic centimeter or gram per cc or kg per cubic meter is the unit of density. Substances whose density is more than that of water sink in water. Substances whose density is less than that of water float on water. Ice floats on water as density of water 1 gram per cc, density of ice 0.9 gram per cc, density of ice is less than the density of water. So, ice floats on water. What happens to aquatic animals when rivers and lakes freeze in winter? Do they remain alive? Have you seen penguins breaking the ice layer and eating fish from it?